Okay, Whisperer in the Darkness, Kapitel 4. 4, 4, 4, 4. Something in the way Akeley presented his discoveries and theories thereof prompted me to continue our discussion, despite my initial doubts. Despite my measured trust for him, I contacted his old professors to verify that he was indeed the mature scholar he claimed, thus dispelling my suspicion of his messages as part of an elaborate farce. This and the clear rationality which characterized his early correspondence prevented me from discounting his experiences. In addition to the Blackstone, Akeley had one more tangible piece of evidence. He actually managed to record a minute or two of what he had described as ritual chanting, which he heard one night in the woods. He sent me the audio file at my eager persuasion. You may have heard it yourself, if you've yet delved into the accursed hard drive containing every communication which ever passed between us. Upon first listening, my heart was struck cold, and I began to truly believe the wider claims Akeley put forth. His careful distance from the speakers was evident in the way their voices carried through the trees. Carried through the trees no louder than whispers. Still, I will never forget the few words I could hear above all the rest. Is the Lord of the Woods even to of night to the gulfs of space, and from the gulfs of space to the wells of night, ever the praises of great Cthulhu. And it has come to pass that the Lord of the Woods,
on the wings of the night, out beyond space, out beyond. Go out among humans and find the ways thereof, that ye in the gulf may know. Yalathotep, he, the great messenger. Down from the world of seven suns to mock. And he shall put on the semblance of them, the masking flesh and the robe that hides.
Next was the matter of the Black Stone. Akeley claimed to have found it in the woods on Round Hill. Its unknown hieroglyphics nearly worn away, perhaps from centuries of age, or even millennia. He soon began to display a certain paranoia over the stone's discovery. Once he took it home, he claimed that everything changed, that he might be killed or taken should they decide his curiosity had overreached. After puzzling over the stone's symbols for weeks, Akeley believed he was on the cusp of unraveling its secrets. We agreed that if he could send it to me safely, I might be able to find the last crucial piece needed to translate the glyphs. I managed to convince him to drive into Townshend and ship the stone from there. Okay, ein Stein wird verschickt. Endlich passiert was. Its estimated date of arrival came and went. Wahrscheinlich mit Hermes geschickt. And to my dismay, I received no delivery. Distraught, Akeley concluded the stone must have been intercepted. Now they must be watching him more closely than ever, he realized. I reassured him that it must simply have been an accident, and promptly conducted my own investigation to the status of the delivery. Okay. Boop, 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 boop. Muss mal eben was trinken. Super. Naja, ist ja nur Wasser. Aber trotzdem, irgendwie war das ganz schön durchgeschüttelt. Loading, an error occurred, package 0451 0801 does not exist. Sieht aus wie eine Sylter Telefonnummer. Aber nicht da anrufen, bitte. Vielen Dank. The results were unhelpful. Despite my half-hearted encouragements. Ja, so ist besser. Whoop. Akeley soon abandoned hope that the stone would ever be recovered. Und das ist das vierte Kapitel, das wir beim nächsten Mal weiter behandeln. Okay. Dann würde ich sagen, bis denn. Wird ja langsam spannend. Jetzt verschwinden schon Steine in der Post.